Vibe is underwritten by Kopicki Photography, 300 Cherry Street, Reading, PA, 19602.
Hi, I'm Marcia.
And I'm Jack.
And welcome to Berks Vibe. We have a really interesting show this evening. Do you want to tell them about our cool tape segment?
We had a great tape segment down at the Reading IMAX. We found out what
11
means.
We know how to find it on the internet and that was a big screen, but we'll be getting to that. Yeah. But in a moment, we're going to get to our live segment, which is so cool. I cannot wait. We have magic this evening, and I love magic. I'm a sucker for magic. But first, before we begin, I have a really special birthday wish for Lita Shine. Lita, happy, happy birthday. Yay. So, but now I'd like to introduce our guests. We have Ryan Parsons. And Ryan, you are actually the president of the Mingus Magic Shop Magic Club.
That's correct.
Too many magics in there?
President of the Mingus Magic Club. We're affiliated with the International Brotherhood of Magicians, ring number 57, based here in Reading. We have members from Berks County, Lehigh County, Montgomery County, Chester County, anywhere from Phoenixville to Harrisburg and north of Bethlehem.
So
a lot of different guys, a lot of different
kinds
of talents.
Big club. And then we have Wayne Shifflet, and you're the owner of the Mingus Magic Shop.
Correct.
So welcome both of you.
Thank you for having us.
Oh, our pleasure. Wayne, the Mingus Magic Shop, one, never knew it existed.
We drive by it all the time.
Two, it's one of the oldest magic shops on the East Coast.
That's correct.
So give us the lowdown on Mingus.
Well, actually, it was founded by Leroy Mingus well over 60 years ago, back in the 1940s. And he actually started manufacturing feather flower magic for magicians and supplied magic shops all over the country. He also had a small retail business that people would come in and learn how to do magic. Mm-hmm. And his shop basically was over in West Reading most of the time. And I started hanging out in the shop about the late 60s.
Building flowers,
yeah. I was in the shop so often he put me to work starting to make the flowers and steaming feathers, cutting and trimming feathers. And
so it's like a craft to the magic.
It is, because all the flowers are all made by hand. And there are several different effects that you can do. You may have canes that turn to flowers, umbrellas that turn to flowers, flowers that bloom, they vanish, or it's all sorts of things. So there's a wide range, and they're all used by, like I said, different magicians and even clowns throughout the country.
Cool. So. And you're located where, on Lancaster Avenue?
528 Lancaster Avenue.
Right across from where Gilbert used to
the
be.
The old Gilbert building.
We were saying you made Gilbert's
disappear. Right, we made the front part of the building disappear. Now we have to try to get the rest of it back to the way it was. That's going to be another trick.
But you sell magic tricks, clown stuff, right. Unicycles.
Juggling equipment.
All kinds of stuff.
Yes, basically a lot of stuff for children's entertainers. Anybody who wants to entertain children, whether you do it by magic, puppetry, mime, clowning, juggling. There's also a local juggling club that meets in Reading also.
So we supply.
Just the basics. I can juggle. I'm not very good at it.
Mm-hmm.
Just the basic juggling.
Freshman year in college, I learned to juggle.
And it's like riding a bike. Once you learn how to do it, that's it. You'll never forget it.
Jack can whistle, too.
Oh, really? Great.
We'll have to demonstrate that for us.
There's a lot of stupid human tricks,
okay.
Jack, but we won't get into that.
Thank you, Matt.
Jack will be whistling later on if anyone is interested.
No.
I'm not.
But anyway, you have a really kind of cool thing that goes on the first and third Saturdays.
Right, we do magic at 2 on the first and third, and we put on a magic show at 2 o'clock. We have a small theater set up in the back of the store. We do it on the first and third Saturday of the month. And we look for our local magicians to volunteer their time, and it's about a half-hour show. It's open to the public. It's free. Anybody can come in and watch the show. And I'll either do a few things before or after. And if we don't have any volunteers, I'll end up doing the show. But usually we get some of the local magicians to volunteer.
Free show and free popcorn.
Free popcorn.
And there is a little theater in the magic shop that
18 seats.
Actual theater seats. I have an old theater.
And the back
of the magic shop is a small stage. It's renovated with some lights and a lot of neat magic memorabilia as well.
Cool.
So it's a cool place that
kind of
a lot of people don't know about. It's a little bit of a museum, it's a little bit of a show place, and it's a neat place to come and watch a show, especially since the shows are free and open to the public.
And it's also a place where we have two local clubs that meet there, so that's our meeting place also.
Right.
It gives magicians a chance to maybe try out some new material.
That's what I was thinking, practice, getting used to being in front of an audience, all that kind of stuff.
Right. It's kind of like an open mic for magicians.
Neat. And you were saying, too, you don't just sell the tricks, because we were talking about the code of ethics and all of that. And I was saying, I don't want to know how it's done. I just enjoy the magic. But if someone comes in and buys a trick, you kind of check out their level and make sure you tell them a trick they can do. But it's all practice.
Sure. We try to figure out what skill level they're at. If they're just beginning, we're going to teach them the basic magic tricks, because you have to build a foundation first. You can't start, you know, levitating things and having things float around the room first.
Right.
You have to do the basic, learn just the basic skills before you can really advance beyond that.
Cool.
So we'll show the basic beginner stuff and teach them how to do it, aside from just giving the instructions. Because really, imagine what you're buying. You're actually buying a secret. Now, you do get the props to perform the trick, but you are buying a secret. So once you purchase that trick, and you pay your $5 or $10 for the trick, you have received full value of the trick, and there's really no returns on it, because now you know how that trick is done.
Exactly.
So,
and it's up to you to practice
exactly.
it.
Exactly.
Then you have to do it. You said one trick you learn.
You must practice over
500
and over.
Times.
Yeah, I mean, it's doing magic is a lot like learning to play a musical instrument, or learning to do any real skill or art or anything like that.
If you want to do it well.
Right. Exactly. If you want to do it well, you have to start out at a beginner level, and you have to work your way up to be able to perform at a certain level. And you know, with magic, it's a little bit different, because you don't want to just run right out and perform your trick, because that will sort of tip the audience to let them know maybe the secret.
If you fumble or something like that.
So what you want to do is you want to practice your trick, make sure you're really, really good at it, and you know that you can perform it perfectly every time, then go out to an audience and present it to a group of people.
We have a home viewer. We never get home viewers. Hello?
Is it my brother-in-law?
Hello?
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 Hi.
Hi.
On TV. You're on TV. Yes, I'm on TV.
You are. Do you want to ask a question?
What? How can we help you?
I love you.
Does she love us?
I guess so. Well, thank you.
Must have been for you, Jack.
It must have been. It must have been. So, but Ryan, you. The Mingus Magic Shop Club.
Yes.
But you don't just, obviously it's a vehicle for magicians to get together and learn from each other, but
right.
you also do a lot of different fundraisers.
Right. Basically what our club is, it's sort of a social group, half social group for magicians. The other half of our function is to help better ourselves as performers. We get together once a month, we meet, we talk about magic, we help each other learn different topics, learn about different tricks, practice in front of one another. So that's sort of half of our goal is that. And the other half of our goal is to reach out into the community and to do different things. And we try to do different activities throughout the community. Throughout the year, we do a couple of different things. One of the big things that we have is coming up this Saturday. It's a show, actually two shows, to benefit Habitat for Humanity. The first show's at 3 o'clock, second show's at 7 o'clock p.m. It's at Bethany Lutheran Church in Stony Creek, right on Friedensburg Road. You park on Parsonia Avenue. Tickets are $5 each, and this is the second year we're doing it. All the proceeds go to Habitat for Humanity.
Okay.
That's great.
So, Jay Worrell, he was there last year. He'll be at our shows this year. He's big with Habitat for Humanity from Berks County. All the money that we make, stays in Berks County to help build homes as well for Berks County. So
very good.
That's one of our big functions that we do every year. The other one that we do is another one that's sort of really close and personal to our club. 4 years ago, one of our members, Dan Lafferty, his daughter, Shelley, was diagnosed with pediatric cancer. Mm. Well, when all the members of our club found out that, you know, Dan's family needed some assistance and his daughter was ill, we decided to put on a magic show to raise money. And our initial goal was to just give money to his family and say, look, you know, do whatever you need to do. Let's pay some insurance. Let's pay your bills. Let's do whatever, you know. Unfortunately, as we were planning the show and we were developing it, his daughter ended up passing away. She passed away Christmas Day 2005, so we miss Shelley every day, but we do this show every year for her. And this is the fourth year we'll be doing the show this year. It's in October. We call the show Magic for Miracles. We have a website, www.magicformiracles.com, and four spelled F-O-R. All the money we raise gets donated to Alex's Lemonade Stand, which is a great pediatric cancer research charity.
Yep.
It all goes in Shelley's honor. And in the last 3 years, we've raised over $10,000 that we give to Alex's Lemonade Stand.
That's fabulous.
Look for us in October, ML Bausch Elementary School in Exeter.
Yep.
Check the website for information, and it's a great event. And that's something that's very personal to us as a club and all of our members, because it's something that directly affected one of our guys, and we said, you know, we want to help, you know, one of our own, you know, one of the guys who are in our club.
That's awesome. So somebody wants to be a magician, is a magician, How can they kind of hook into your club or find out about it?
The best thing to do is come into the Mingus Magic Shop.
Come to the Magic Shop.
And stay. Don't just walk in. Sure. Right, hang around. Right. We'll demonstrate some magic for you. So if you...
What are your hours? I mentioned
right now, we're open Thursdays and Fridays from 6 to 8, Saturdays 12 to 5.
Okay.
Or you can call and schedule an appointment if that's more convenient. Okay. Our hours are somewhat limited. This is a hobby for us, as it is for most people, so mm-hmm. it's not my full-time job.
Okay.
But, I mean, the best thing to do for people to learn about magic is come into the magic shop. Wayne'll demonstrate some tricks for you. He'll show you a little bit of what the magic is about. If you're interested in buying the trick, he'll show you how to do the trick. So mm-hmm. you can leave the magic shop that day knowing how to perform something.
Well, and that's helpful, because then you can go home and practice it.
Right, practice it, and then show your friends and your family and
just amaze them.
Exactly.
Absolutely. Right.
That's very cool.
Well, that's what magic's about. It's not really about fooling people, it's about entertaining people.
Yeah, and that's what I like. Everyone's like, oh, that's a magic trick. Like, well, no duh. But why can't you just enjoy it for what it is?
And that's why we do it. We do it for our entertainment value.
And kids still today seem to enjoy it.
Sure. Absolutely. They do, yes. We still get people coming in all the time. There's always new generations coming through learning magic. It's been a art that's been around for thousands of years, and it's going to continue.
Excellent. Well, I think without further ado, we should do some magic.
Why don't we?
So I think Wayne, you're up first. Why don't you tell everybody who the special assistant is, Jack?
The special assistant is my daughter, Sarah.
Very good.
Welcome. I'm going to be meeting Sarah in a few minutes. You can step over here, Sarah. I want you to check this out. And actually, this is the very first trick I learned how to do many, many years ago. And it's done with three balls and three cups. I want you to watch very carefully. I'm going to place a ball on the middle cup, and at the count of three, watch what happens. We go one, two, three, goes right through. Okay, let's do that again. Got one, we'll try the second ball, and again, on the count of three, we go one, two, three, that one goes through. Here we got two through, one more to go. Here we go. And again, on the count of three, one, two, three, they're all through. But now we're going to do the hard part, Sarah. The hard part is actually finding the fourth ball. The reason the fourth ball is hard to find is because it's invisible. They're a little more difficult to see. If you stand still, right on top of Sarah's head is the fourth invisible ball. See that? Watch, we'll put that on the middle cup. The count of three, watch the invisible ball. Here we go. One, whoop, fell off. Let's get it back on time. Here we go. Watch, one, two, three, and there's the fourth ball. Thank you. That actually is a level one trick. It's very easy to do for beginners. You just have to understand how the trick works. But here's one that's going to be a little more difficult. Now, this one I do need your help on. You want to check those out. Just make sure there's no cuts, pockets, or anything hidden inside either one of those. They look okay? Kind of like squishy balls? Good. All right, watch very carefully. This ball, I'm going to take place in my hand. I'm going to give you the other ball. Close your hand real tight as you can. Hold it up in the air like that. The ball in my hand, we're going to make it vanish. It's actually going to disappear. It's going to float through the air while it's invisible, go through your fingers, materialize in the palm of your
hand. I watched
Did you feel it go through your fingers? Open up your hand and show everybody how many you have. You got them both. Very good. You didn't know you could do that, did you? And of course, a lot of people do card tricks. Card tricks is a staple for magicians, so we're going to try something out here with this pack of cards. Just going to cut the deck a few times. As I go through the pack, I want you to tell me when to stop. Right there, take a look at that top card. You can show it to the camera, show it to everybody at home. There we have it. Doesn't matter if I see the card or not. Show everybody over there. I've got that card. Put it back on top of the deck. That was the 10 of diamonds, right? Watch. If we cut the deck a few times, one more cut, the 10 of diamonds actually comes back to the top of the deck. Pretty neat. Okay, now watch it again. We're going to take the 10 of diamonds on top of the deck. If I just cut it one time and hit it hard enough, your card will come back to the top of the deck. Okay, and as you can see, we're going to take and cut the deck. We're going to make four piles. Here we go. Now, Sarah, what I'd like you to do is point to a pile. That's actually where the 10 of diamonds is. See, it doesn't matter which pile you would have pointed to, Sarah. Oh, we have different, we have two tens, a seven and a two. And I'll tell you what, if we put all these back like this here, and we take and we cut to a 10 of diamonds, I will actually make the whole deck turn into the 10 of diamonds. Every card is now the 10. Understand that? Except, of course, for all the ones that are different. Because if they're different, they can't be the same, can they? No, I didn't think so. All right. And another thing a lot of magicians do, they have top hats. Here we have our top hat. A top hat on this side, a top hat on that side. You know what magicians pull out of top hats there?
Rabbit.
Exactly, watch. Make a rabbit come there. Rabbit's over there, and a rabbit's over there. Now, if I rub the bottom like this, he'll disappear on that side, but he stays on this side. If I turn him over, rub it again, he disappears on both sides. But he can come back on that side and that side, or just vanish on that side. And you can check that out, too, to make sure there's no rabbits sitting on there. Okay. And hold on to that handkerchief. We have a purple handkerchief there, and I have a yellow handkerchief here. Watch very carefully. Now, this I would consider maybe like a skill level 2, not necessarily for beginners, but one that's nonetheless easy to do. If we take a purple handkerchief, stick it down inside a yellow handkerchief, all the way to a point where you can't see it, that's when it vanishes. Totally disappears. Very simple. It's about 25 years of practice.
Yeah. Only 25.
Nothing in my hand.
It's amazing.
Nothing up my sleeves. Watch very carefully. Again, if I snap my fingers, reach inside, and make that handkerchief come back again, just like that. I really don't need two handkerchiefs. We could put this one away. And let me just use a purple one. To stick that down inside my fist there all the way, watch. Oh my goodness. Totally disappears. If you look right here, and if you look over here, if I do this here, we can actually make that handkerchief come back out again. All right, thank you for helping me out, Sarah.
Very nice.
Thank you. And as I said, one of the tricks that Leroy started making many, many years ago is our flower tricks. And this is one of the most popular flower tricks that we do make anymore. We sell these to a lot of clowns, for those of you who are not afraid of clowns.
Oh, clowns.
But we can actually take that yellow flower off like that and make it totally disappear. And it's totally gone. So now you have to go home and make another one. we'll put this away. I think Ryan has a few things he might like to show you as well.
Yay! Sure.
I would be happy to. Wonderful. Thank you, Wayne.
Thanks, Wayne.
Thank you. I'm going to push you off to the side here. Okay. All right. I've had this trick. You know, I've been wanting to do this trick on television forever.
Well, here's your chance.
Forever. And I've never been on television before up until today. This is a cool trick I do. I do it with one piece of white rope and one piece of red rope. And the reason I've been wanting to do this trick on television forever is because it has this great line in it. For those of you at home who are watching this with a black and white screen television, the dark-colored rope, the light-colored rope. We're magicians, not comedians, folks. Okay, here's what we're going to do. We're going to start this trick off with tying a little knot inside of the white piece of rope. What I'm going to do, actually, Sarah, did you want to come back up here and join me for just a second? Do you know any magic words, Sarah?
Abracadabra.
That's a very common one. If you could just say abracadabra to these ropes. Say it nice and loud.
Abracadabra.
Abracadabra. Let's see if we can make the magic happen. I think we did make the magic happen.
That's good.
We have a red rope with a knot in it. Boy, that's pretty impressive, huh? Do you know what kind of knot this is? It's a slip knot. Here, I'll demonstrate. Watch. I can actually slip the knot right down off the rope, just like that. Would you like to see it jump back onto the rope? Check this out. Watch. Pretty cool?
That is.
This is the coolest part of the trick. Do you see this knot inside the rope? I'm going to make it slide one more time to the end of the rope. Let's see if I can do this. Watch. Just like that. Here's the cool part of the trick, because when you said abracadabra, I think you really might have done some magic, because when we look at this rope, you will see that this is actually a knot. It's a white piece of rope on a red piece of rope, just like that. Sarah, you're such a good helper. I think I'd like to keep you up here for one more. Would you like to see another trick? I was hoping you were going to say that. Wonderful. This is a really fun trick that I like to do. It's a cool trick. It's a balloon trick. Do you like balloons? Wonderful. I like balloons, too. We're going to do this really cool balloon trick, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to reach down inside this bag, and I'm going to take out a balloon for me, and then I'm going to reach it inside the bag, and I'm going to have you take out a balloon for yourself, okay? So one balloon for me, one balloon for you. Reach inside the bag, take out a balloon, show it to everyone else, and we're going to do this great balloon trick. We're going to do it together. All right, it works better if you pick a different color balloon, so drop that back in there. We will give these balloons a mix, and you can reach down inside the bag. You can pull any balloon you like out. Just reach down inside the bag. Take out your favorite balloon. We're going to start this balloon trick. I think your dad's going to like it. Okay, we'll put that back in the bag. Reach down inside the bag. Pull out any balloon you like. Show it to the audience at home. We're going to do this great balloon trick. Okay. Here, hold on to that one. Let's make this a little easier. Take the yellow ones out, and we'll put those on the bottom. Just drop those in the bottom of the bag there. There you go. One more, maybe two. There you go. We'll put those in the bottom of the bag. We'll put all these colored ones on top. Now, Sarah, what I want you to do is reach down inside the bag, take any balloon you like out. We're going to start this great balloon trick. Let's see.
Are you digging at the bottom?
No.
Put that balloon back in the bag. Sarah, what I want you to do is, do you believe in magic? What I want you to do is look at the camera, tell everybody at home, say, Sarah believes in magic.
Can I sit here?
Well, you can if you want, or you can say, I believe in magic.
I believe in magic.
Do you really believe you believe in magic? Wave your hand over the bag and say, I believe in magic. If you really believe in magic, reach down inside that bag and pull out any different color balloon you like. That's pretty good. I think she's doing magic now. Now we can start the trick. Here we go. We're going to teach you how to make a balloon animal. Okay? Are you ready? Stretch your balloon out like this. This is the first part. It's like exercise, but fun. Okay. Stretch it out, and then what you're going to do is blow up your balloon. Go ahead. Blow up your balloon, and then I'm going to teach you how to tie it in a knot, and we're going to do the trick. Go ahead. Give it a shot. Do you want me to go first? Okay. What we will do?
Sarah.
Who said this was cheating?
Oh, okay.
What we will do is we will blow up our balloon just like this. And I will actually show you how to make a balloon animal, Sarah, just like this. We give one little twist like that. We're going to make a dog. That gives us our little doggy nose. One twist like that, one twist like that. We have a pair of doggy ears. One more twist gives us a doggy neck. A couple of doggy front legs. A doggy body, doggy back legs, and a doggy tail, just like so. And with a little bit of luck, a fancy doggy. Pretty cool. I'll give you that one. You can take this balloon. I will take that. You will take that balloon. I will take this balloon. I will blow this one up for you, and I will show you one more time, nice and slow, how you can make a balloon dog for yourself. Just like this, we will tie it in a knot. One twist for a doggy nose, one twist for ears. We'll make this one a little bit different. We will give him a little neck. Some front legs, some back legs. And should we give him that same fancy tail? What do you think? Not bad. You can keep this balloon for yourself. You can keep this one for a friend. And thank you for helping me out.
Very nice.
Thank you. Oh, mild applause. Thank you, Jack. I appreciate that.
That was kind of lackluster. There you go.
I strive for mild applause. That's my goal.
Now are you going to cut Marsh in half, or?
Is that a request?
I'll remember that, Jack.
Actually, what I'd like to do is I would like to show everybody how I do a magic trick. Sort of teach you how a trick works. I'll show you the trick two times, and then I will show you how the trick actually works. Does that sound fair?
Sure.
Like any good magic trick, it needs a little bit of preparation. I have this trick here in my pocket, and it's a cool trick. Here we go. Yes, like I said, I'll show you the trick twice, and then I'll actually show you how to do the trick. The first step is you need a silk handkerchief. Mine is wrinkly. It's just a little old. Here's the trick. Watch. I take the silk handkerchief, and I place it down inside of my hand, all the way down inside, all the way down inside. Just like that, so the handkerchief is gone, and then as if by magic, we turn the handkerchief into an egg. Pretty good?
That is pretty good.
Were you paying attention, Jack?
I didn't see any egg going in your hand.
Well, that's pretty good. Now, the handkerchief actually ends up over here in my pocket. So now I will show you how to do this trick one more time. Okay, Jack?
Okay.
Handkerchief is in this hand. You're watching closely now?
I am.
Jack is paying attention, which is very good. We're going to take the handkerchief and we're going to place it down inside of my hand, all the way down, all the way down, all the way down, until, as if by magic, we turn the handkerchief into an egg. Now, I bet you're all wondering how this trick is done, and I did promise you that I would tell you. There is a secret.
To pay you.
No.
Okay.
This one's on the house.
Okay.
There is a secret to this trick, as there are with most tricks. Here is the secret. This is not a real egg. This is a hollow plastic egg, just like that. They call this a magician's egg, not because it was laid by a magician, but of course because we use it to do magic. So here's how the trick works. I have the silk handkerchief in my right hand. I have the egg hidden in my left pocket. I come out, place the handkerchief inside of the hole in the back of the egg. That's how the trick works. So from the beginning.
How do you cover up the hole?
Well, we'll get to that part.
Okay.
Here's how the trick works. You take out the egg. You hide the egg in your hand. That's the most important part. You make sure that the egg is hidden in your hand so that no one in the audience can see it. And then you place the handkerchief down inside of that hole in the back of the egg. All the way down inside, all the way down inside. Till there's no more handkerchief left, And then, as if by magic, voila. Pretty good?
Pretty good.
But Jack, if you were going to do this trick to your friends, one thing important to note, you do not want to show them the back of the egg. Always hold the egg like this, never hold the egg like this. Sort of ruins the fun for everyone else, okay? But if you ever get yourself in this position, you happen to show the back of the egg. Do not panic. Just do this. Because if you really believe in magic,
my goodness,
and you've been practicing, you can do this.
Oh, wow.
Thank you. Thank you. How about one more?
One more.
Sarah, you got time for one more? Come on up. One more. This is one of my favorite magic tricks. Oh, nothing but the best props for Sarah. Do you know what this is? You're close. It's a napkin. This is a cool trick we're going to do with the napkin. I'm going to take this napkin, and I'm going to fold it up. And then I'm going to tear it. And when I tear it, I'm going to tear a perfect hole right in the center, a perfect circle right in the center of the napkin. Do you think that would be a cool trick? All right. Let's see. I'm going to even show you how it's done. First things first, fold the napkin in half like so. Secondly, you fold the napkin up like this. Thirdly, you fold the napkin right about there. Now we're getting to the hard part. Sarah, are you right-handed or left-handed?
Right.
Very good. I'm right-handed as well. One last fold of the napkin. Now, Sarah, I'm going to start to tear through the napkin. I don't want to tear completely through. I'm going to leave this last little piece hanging on for you. This piece is going to be your souvenir. So what I want you to do is take your souvenir, rip it off, just like that. Put that in your hand, close up your fist. Very good. Now, how good of a circle do you think we made? Let's see. Not bad?
Pretty good.
Pretty good.
You say pretty good, Jack?
Very good.
Outstanding?
Okay. That's not bad.
Phenomenal?
You're getting closer. Jack, could you come up and help me out?
Okay.
I'm sorry, I can come
over.
I think
you can come over.
Okay. You're not impressed with this?
Yeah.
Okay, you're not. It's obvious. That's not a problem. Hold on to that part. We're going to do a little trick with you, Jack, since I impressed you so much with the last one, we will do a trick here. We're going to play a little game of guess which hand the napkin is in.
Oh,
it's a fun game all the kids are playing. You play this at school, right? All the time. All the time. Okay, guess which hand the napkin is in. Ready?
Okay.
Guess which hand.
Oh, geez, I lost it already.
it's a 50-50 shot, Jack. It's
this hand.
You're good.
Okay.
Okay. You've played this game before, I can tell. One more time, I'll give you another shot. Guess which hand the napkin is in.
This one.
We're even. Tied up.
Okay.
Double or nothing. Okay, Jack, what I want you to do is keep your eye on the napkin. This time we're going to go a little quicker. Which hand is the napkin in?
Neither. It's in your pocket.
That would be a good guess. Actually, Sarah, this part here is the center of the napkin. It's fun to bring up your dad and embarrass him just a little bit. But we do know who the star of the show is, don't we? Who's the star of the show?
You are right.
Absolutely not. Sarah.
Oh, Sarah.
Sarah. This is your dad? And next week on Berks 5, Sarah, since you are the star of our show, do you remember what the center of our napkin looked like? That nice circle torn in the center? It's over there behind your dad's head if you want to examine it later. If we look at the center of our napkin now, you will see that we do not have that nice circle that was torn in the center of the napkin. But if we look now, you will see that we have a star. And Sarah, since you are such a star for helping us out with our magic today, you get to keep this as a souvenir. Thank you very much,
nice.
Jack.
Very
you.
Nice.
Sarah, thank you.
Very good.
Brian, thank you, guys.
Thank you so much.
No problem. Wayne,
that was so much fun.
Yeah, great.
I just love magic. I'm going to have to come see their little
definitely.
Magic.
Definitely. Magic gets you.
Stop 2
o'clock.
Absolutely.
2 o'clock,
so.
Is that when it is?
2 Saturday? O'clock, first and third Saturdays.
First and third Saturdays. Yep. Outstanding.
Great.
Right. Wonderful.
Well, thank you both so much.
It was our pleasure.
All right. Yep. Very good.
In stereo.
Okay, there you go.
Well, I think we're ready for our world-famous top five.
Okay.
So I'm not sure who the lucky one is, who's are going to go up first. That was pretty good. You did really well.
Thank you.
Yeah, you were born to be a magic assistant. There you go.
I can read that better.
Yeah, I can read
but
that.
But I brought my own cheat sheet.
All right.
In honor of Mother's Day breakfast, Sunday, May 10th, from 7 a.m. until 10:30 a.m. at Nativity Lutheran Church, 13th and Amity Streets in Reading, $5.50 for adults, children 12 and under, $3. A portion of the proceeds are donated to Berks Enduring Freedom and the Lutheran Pantry.
What's that, Berks Enduring Freedom?
I think it has something to do with troops.
Oh, okay. And
sorry, Marsh, I didn't.
No, it's okay. I just didn't know.
Number two, Reading Area Community College Concert Choir Spring Concert at Rax Miller Center for the Arts, Tuesday, May 12th at 7 o'clock, and it's free. For information, dial 610-372-4721, extension 5500. And number three, third annual Family Fun Day, Saturday, May 16th, from 10 a.m. until 2 p.m., features some great stuff. Moon Bounce, you like that, Sarah, don't you? Train rides.
You like the Moon Bounce.
I do. I'm a little big, but. Balloon animals? Are you doing balloon animals, Ryan?
Not at this particular event, but I'm sure there's somebody very nice doing balloon animals at this one.
Face painting, pony rides, food, beverage, and a lot more. Benefits shop, I think that's Children's Hospital of Philadelphia, Metabolic Disease Research Department. Tickets are $10 in advance. You can go to www.angelinafoundation.org. Number four, Berks County Summer Concert Series starts Sunday, May 24th from 6 p.m. until 8 p.m. and goes through August. The first band is the Ringgold Band at Grings Mill. And for more information, go to the series. Go to www.countyofberks.com/parks.
Those are nice events.
Yeah, I haven't been to one, but they look like fun.
Yeah.
And I know my parents have been there. Number five, Fiddle Festival, May 30th from 10 a.m. until 7 p.m. Long day.
Yeah.
At the Berks
That's
County.
That's a lot of fiddling.
That is a lot of fiddling. It looks like they have a big lineup of performers. It's at the Berks County Heritage Center, and you can go to www.countyofberks.com/parks again.
All right. I like the little swirl. See, now I can read that. I think John changed it for me, so I didn't have to squint.
Glare, Marcia, you're getting old.
I know. That's what my eye doctor told me. The glare bothers me now. Anyway, Touch a Truck, that's Sunday, May 17th, and this is the Junior League is doing this. And it sounds really cool for kids. They're going to bring all kind of trucks and cars and machinery and all kind of things that kids just love, and they're going to be allowed to climb on it, scramble it, touch it to their heart's desire. Those are their exact words. Their favorite vehicles and trucks. So it's $5 per person, but children will get in free if they bring a canned good donation. It's at the Penn State Berks campus. There's a number if you want more information, but you can just show up. Especially if your kid likes fire trucks and all that kind of stuff.
Who's the benefit? They're giving the kid
the junior. Well, that I don't know, but it's the Junior League doing it, and they do a lot of work with children. Like I think their cause is children, so they do a lot of different things. So this is the second one is the quilt show at the Kutztown Area Historical Society, and it's every Sunday in May. And it's 32 quilts from the collection of Pat and Arlen Crist, and they're amazing quilts. I saw them, but they're from the Civil War, and they're all from this area, the wow. quilts that were made. And it's quite a history, and it's quite interesting, and it's all quilts that they've collected, and this just happens to be the local ones from this area, so it has a lot of local
Are they selling quilts from the Civil War?
They're not selling them, but there is a raffle. They did donate one for a raffle, and it was like real affordable, the raffle cost. So if you're into quilts, definitely check that show out at the Kutztown Historical Society. Neversink Mountain, the Berks Conservancy, the Berks County Conservancy, that's part of what they're involved in is the trails and whatnot on Neversink Mountain. But they're going to have a hike on Sunday, May 17th at 1. But you need to call and register because they'll tell you where to meet. I think there's a fee, I'm not sure, but if it is, it benefits the Berks County Conservancy. So there's the phone number to call to register and get directions. Then this one, number four.
That's like a good one, Marcia.
That's going to be a great one. Mm-hmm. The community-wide yard sale in College Heights, Saturday, May 30th, and that starts at 8 a.m. I know who coordinated that. Oh, 7.
Yeah, that's 7.
I asked coordinated him to change it.
So it's 7 o'clock. College Heights. Where's College Heights?
Right behind Albright College. Okay. So 7 a.m. That's the typo. So, and then the last one is the 5th Annual Why Not Awards. And if you don't know what that is, It's all the local high schools. They all perform their plays, and there's a lot of outstanding young local teen talent in our community, and we're finally recognizing that talent. So this is the 5th annual Why Not Awards, come out and support them. And that's May 20th at 7 at the Sovereign Performing Arts Center.
Is that like high school plays?
Yeah, like you know when Central had their play? They didn't do that kind of stuff when we were in school, but now they actually have a panel that goes around and they view them, and they have best actor, best actress, best all that kind of, all those different categories. Oh, so recognizing the hard work that goes into those plays. It is a lot of work, and they put a lot of heart and soul into it, and they deserve to get recognized for it. But I think it's a fun evening because they do bits and pieces from their shows. So.
Oh, I think. Yeah. I know in Allentown, I think they do the, is it the Freddy's? Is that what they call it?
Something the Freddy's like or something like that. Yeah.
Well, it looks like fun.
Yeah, I think so. Good. So anyway, well now we're going to go to our tape segment, and we had fun.
Oh, we did have fun. We were down at the Reading IMAX. Yeah. 11, and 11 means 11 theaters. So.
You think we would have known that?
Seems like it makes sense. But, we met with General Manager Dave Campbell, and we talked a lot about what IMAX is and everything about the theaters and what movies are coming in. And we have some movies we're thinking about going to see.
Yeah, so. Definitely. So, all right.
Hi, I'm Jack.
And I'm Marcia.
And we're at the IMAX Theater in downtown Reading.
Do you think they can tell we're at the IMAX?
Oh my goodness, Marcia, we're dwarfed.
Do you think, I mean, I'm short to begin with, but this is just comical.
Marcia, we look thin.
Do you think we look thin?
I think we do.
I bet from this far away we look really thin. How great is this? This is a huge screen, and being this close makes it even huger. It's kind of freaky, actually. It'd be like a tidal wave, like falling over.
Do you think we'd be drowned by the sound if it was on right now?
Yeah, I think so. Do you think we should tell people why we have our fabulous glasses on?
Heard a 3D movie.
A 3D IMAX movie. Like, wow. So, but we're going to go actually talk and get some of the lowdown on what IMAX really means. And I want to know how big this screen is now that I'm really looking at it.
And I'll hope Dave knows all the answers.
I think Dave will have all the answers. Shall we go chat?
Yes, let's
all right,
to.
Okay.
Hi, we're here with Dave Campbell, General Manager of the IMAX Theater in Reading. And what's the official name of the theater?
The official name is the Reading Movies 11 and IMAX at Entertainment Square.
Wow.
It's a long name.
That's a long name.
Reading Movies 11 will do.
You know, I just noticed that you kind of match the seats. Yeah. Is that like plan? You look really snazzy.
I guess my wardrobe just morphed through the building.
That's very good. I like these seats, by the way.
Yeah. Flattened back a little bit more than you.
I noticed that, and I said, "Is that because you're, you know, heavier?"
More manly.
But these are lovely and very comfortable.
Yeah, they're great seats. I mean, every auditorium has the same seating. They're fully reclining stadium seating, and actually, cup holders go up as well for more comfort, so you can have
demonstrate.
Cup holders.
Oh,
man.
Wow, the creature comforts.
Exactly.
It's like sitting in an airplane. Look at that.
How many people is this seat?
This is around 350 seats in here.
Marcia, you wouldn't do well. No. Too many people.
Too many people, too claustrophobic. Speaking of that, though, when we were standing by the screen, how big is that screen? That thing is massive, and when you're up against it, it's really massive.
It is a very large screen. It's 40 feet tall and 70 feet wide. And that's our IMAX screen. It's really big, and it's, as you can see from when you were standing in front and sitting here, it really adds to the immersion of the IMAX experience.
The immersion. See, we need to learn the IMAX talk.
What was the other word you used, Dave? The cutting, the bringing down of the movie. We're going to stop a movie. What was that called?
Oh, the dropping. Yeah, that's it. Yeah, we have our own lingo in the
you
theater.
Sure do. You sure do. But speaking of lingo, IMAX, does it stand for something? What does it mean? I think sometimes people see it and they're like, oh, that really big screen, but there's a lot that goes into making an IMAX film.
IMAX and IMAX 3D refer to a couple different things. We're in an IMAX auditorium with an IMAX screen, so it's a large format screen. It's, you know, why we have that big screen. And it also, more than that, refers to audio system, which is custom designed for IMAX. It's a very powerful system to reproduce the sounds of these really explosive and powerful movies. There's also different types of films in the IMAX. There's IMAX and IMAX 3D, both on the same large screen. And there's even within that, regular IMAX movies that are filmed and made by the IMAX Corporation. Right now we have Space Station 3D and Under the Sea 3D. Both of those are filmed by IMAX with special IMAX cameras to really give that full screen immersive experience. And then there's also regular Hollywood films. So right now we're playing Monsters vs. Aliens in IMAX. So that film has been taken and remastered for the IMAX screen. And that our next one will be Star Trek, and then Night at the Museum after that. So they take all sorts of Hollywood films and do them in the IMAX format so that you can get that great immersive experience.
It's very cool, and it's, I think a lot of people are afraid sometimes to come because they get sick, car sick or whatever, but you're telling me, in fact, I even said to you, I don't do 3D movies really well because I'm terribly claustrophobic, and I don't like the way all that comes at me, but you were telling me it's a little different now, that it's not as queasy inducing.
Right. Modern 3D is much different than the, you know, the red and blue glasses of the past. We have our IMAX glasses here, which are polarized lenses.
We look good in them, didn't we, Marsha?
I think so.
Actually, in an effort to be green, these are all recyclable. We collect them at the end of the show and reuse them. We have a cleaning system that cleans them up, so try and be as green as possible with those.
Great.
And this auditorium was specifically designed for the new IMAX kind of idea where we show the IMAX 3D, the immersive films, but instead of being a more vertical rake, you know, the theater is laid back more, it's very comfortable. You're set back from the screen, you still get the immersion because of the size. So it's more comfortable feeling, and the 3D is more about the depth of field, the depth of vision. It gives you the impression of being in the movie, in the event, versus, you know, stuff jumping out of the screen. Mm-hmm. There's still a little bit of that for fun, but it's really the most amazing thing about 3D now in IMAX and in our regular 3D auditoriums is the immersion, is that depth of field.
Well, you don't have the seats rocking back
and forth.
In the typical some of the things that you've gone to, I've gone to and gotten
the event rides, Six Flags and stuff like that. Yeah, this is, I mean, it's a regular movie theater with stadium seating. It's very comfortable. You know, it's really about the immersion of your field of view and the immersion of the audience, both visually and audibly with the sound.
What's the best seat? Because I think people tend to want to run all the way to the top. And now that you said that, it's not as steep as a normal IMAX where, you know, you feel like your nose is going to bleed. But where is the best seat, or is it really kind of just a preference?
Well, all the seats are great. You get the great immersion from any seat in this auditorium. Personally, I generally sit, you know, in the middle and in about three rows back from where you guys are, because that's kind of the center of the screen. You know, that's my ideal seat, but I've watched a film from any seat in this auditorium, and they're all great.
Very good.
That'd be a nice day. Sit and watch movies all day.
Wouldn't that be grand? All by yourself. Mm-hmm. I remember the big fat Greek wedding?
Yes.
It was like, yes. Well, it was out forever and ever and ever. And finally, my husband and I decided to go see it. We were the only ones in the theater. That's the way I like to see a movie. Yeah. So do you have private viewings? Do you have, I know you have a party room we want to talk about, but can somebody rent the IMAX out?
Sure, we actually do private functions. You know, if a group wants to come in and watch a movie all by themselves, we can do a private event for them, usually during the daytime before we open to the public is the easiest time to accommodate groups like that. So companies, organizations, anybody can come down with a group, and you know, if they are interested in that, just contact us here at the theater, and you can have your private movie experience.
You had a private movie showing last night. Mm-hmm. Tell us a little bit about that.
Yes, we did a benefit event for the Gift of Life Foundation, and they brought in a movie. It was actually from 2000. It was Return to Me with David Duchovny, and they had an event to raise some money and raise awareness for Gift of Life. Mm-hmm. And that went really well. They had a little reception down in the party room and did a gift basket raffle. So it's great. And we do community events like that. We also do a program with the Berks Arts Council and the Greater Reading Film Festival. We do the fourth Sunday of every month. We have a independent or documentary film that they show. It's kind of neat. We try to do some different things, and all of those usually have a panel discussion afterwards, so you get to learn a little bit about the film and about the topics you know, covered in the films. So all sorts of neat stuff going on.
Go ahead. There are how many theaters here?
We have 11 theaters total. We're in the IMAX theater right now, and then there's 10 regular cinemas.
Are they all big like this?
This is the largest of them. There's two on either side of this, which seat 250 seats, so they're very big auditoriums as well. And then the rest of them are around 100 seats. They all have great screens and great sound systems. We use HPS 4000 sound systems and Dolby Digital.
I was going to ask about
the HPS 4000 is actually a custom designed stereo system. It's custom built by a gentleman named John Allen who lives up in Massachusetts. He designs the sound system for every auditorium, comes in personally and moves the speakers, aligns everything so that you get a great experience from every seat in the auditorium. You know, like I said, my preference seat is, you know, three rows up in the middle. His system makes it so that every seat in the auditorium hears the exact same thing. You don't get the sense that if you're sitting on the left side of the room, you don't hear just the left speakers. Mm-hmm. You get everything. You get a full stereo experience in every single seat.
Do you remember the old theaters, like down at Bosco's, and it would just, I know they've been redone, but just like would blare on this side, or you'd blare on this side, and you'd have to sit in the center to get that. That's amazing. I didn't know it was all that. I mean, it's more high-tech than I even thought here, and I was impressed with the airplane seats. They rock, too. Yeah, mine squeaks, though. See, I'd sit next to the person that would rock and squeak.
Well, at least my father would be sleeping and snoring, so that'd bother you.
Well, yeah, in a movie. Anyway, you have another very cool thing you're telling us about, that rewards card. Oh, look at it.
Yeah,
nifty, spiffy.
We just started this. It's our RC rewards program. You can pick up a card at the box office, and what you do is every time you purchase a ticket or purchase popcorn or soda at a concession stand, you give this to the cashier, and they'll swipe the card, and for every dollar you spend, you earn a point. And you accumulate those points towards free soda, free popcorn, and free movies. And the first one starts at 50 points. So once you reach $50, which is usually the second or third time you come down to the movies, you get a free popcorn. So it's kind of neat. It's something to give back and give people, even more of an incentive to come down here and be a frequent customer.
You can sign up for that online, I think.
You can, yeah. If you go to rctheaters.com, there's a sign-up portion on there, and they'll send you one of the cards, or you can pick them up here at the theater.
Well, that was another question. So it's rctheater.com, and that will take you right here to the Reading IMAX Theater?
Actually, that takes you to our corporate site. It's rctheaters.com, R-E-S. And that's our corporate office, or our corporation site. And then we have a subpage on that lists our movie times and special events that we have going on here. And then also there's a section for our rewards program.
Very good.
On the 11, I kind of figured out the 11 is 11 theaters, huh?
That's it.
Oh, yeah.
Figured that out myself.
Oh,
pretty proud.
Very. That's great. And I think, too, we want to touch on, I think you've made it very clear that the parking is free across the street. It can't get any easier.
Oh, it's simple. I zipped
right down Washington, yeah, nice. Bada boom, bada bing. There's even a sign there that says IMAX Theater parking. It's free. I mean, it can't be much easier than that.
No, yeah. I mean, we try and make it as easy for people to come down here. We're located in a great position. We're right next to the bridge, so it's, you know, if you come across the Penn Street Bridge, it's three turns and you're in our parking garage. Mm-hmm. And like you said, free parking. Sometimes during the day, you have to get a ticket from the box office when you purchase your tickets, and use that on your way out.
But at night,
the gates are up, and on the weekends, the gates are up. So you just drive in, watch your movie, and you can head out.
Very nice.
It's very easy, yeah.
Great. And you also have a great concession stand, and you have a video arcade, and do you have any other little goodies out there?
Well, like you mentioned, we have the party room, which is available for functions like the Gift of Life, but mainly it's for birthday parties. You know, if you have a son or daughter and you want to bring them down for a movie, we can use the party room for your cake and ice cream and some snacks, and then you get to watch a movie. So it's kind of a neat function room.
Yeah. The entranceway of the concession area seems like the old theater.
Art Deco-y looking, very, very
cool.
Gave
it a good feel of the old theater of Art Deco.
So do you have jujubes and what are those, snow caps?
Snow caps, yeah.
What else?
You know jujubes? We got all the classic. I know. We have jujufruit, and then we have...
Oh, maybe I'm saying it wrong. Am I saying it wrong?
No, jujufruit is something else, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they're two different ones.
Can you sneak jujubes in if Marcia would...
I don't know about that. We don't allow outside food.
I know the manager, though.
we'll see what we can do for you. But then, no, we have a full concession stand with all sorts of great candies and different sizes and different prices and, you know, popcorns and sodas and icy and ice cream, all sorts of great things, and hot dogs, and we do pizza on the weekends from New York Pizza over in Wyomissing. So they drop off pizza
really
for us.
They have good.
They're nice.
Yeah, it's great. We'll do that on the big opening weekend, so we'll have that for Star Trek. And then all sorts of great things at concession stand, and you can earn points on every one for the free popcorn, soda, and movies.
For all the Trekkies, we'll be here for
I might have to come see the Star Trek. When does that, is that the new one where he's like really young? Is it, and when does that one open?
That opens on May 8th with a full schedule. We actually have a preview on May 7th at 7 p.m. and 10 p.m. That's on Thursday night, and then it opens with a full schedule on Friday, May 8th.
And do people dress for those movies?
They do, yeah. We had, I'm trying to think of the last one, Watchmen. We had people come out and were in costume for that. So, you know, people really...
Not the blue guy.
No, the blue guy. Okay. We didn't have the blue guy. We have Rorschach and a couple of the other guys. But people really get a kick out of it. I mean, for some people that are really into stuff like that, they just enjoy coming out and you know, get to see that movie experience. We're looking forward to Harry Potter this summer, which will be in IMAX. That's in June. That'll be another great film, and I might even dress up for that.
Cool. I love Harry Potter. Can you believe I'm only in the middle of the very last book? Yeah. It took me a while, but don't...
Don't tell me.
Don't tell me. I'll finish it.
And I can't recall. The movie that was filmed at the Pagoda, will that be featured here?
Oh, I'm sure. You know, we'll probably be showing that one when that's released. You know, we hopefully can probably get an event around that towards the opening of it, maybe do a preview of it.
We'd like our special invitations, please.
Certainly. Okay. We'll save you seats.
Okay.
Well, is there anything else you'd like to touch on other than this is an incredibly clean, friendly, the prices, what are the prices, just normal movie prices?
Normal prices, a normal evening ticket is $9.50 for adults for any regular film, and then it's $12 for the IMAX, and we have matinees every day, so any regular film is 6 1/4 before 6 p.m., and then we also have senior and child pricing. We have a rack student pricing. So there's all sorts of different options for that. And we also do discounted tickets. So if you have a business or a group, you can purchase tickets in a quantity of 20 or more, and we can do a discount for that. You just have to contact us here at the theater. Yeah, it's great. And actually, the peanut bar up the street does that, and they offer the tickets to their customers. So if you want to do dinner and movie, you can go up to the peanut bar and have your dinner.
And walk down.
Walk right down, pick up discounted movie tickets.
You have gift cards or gift certificates?
Right. We do gift certificates available in $5 increments. They're great for birthdays and Christmas and holidays and just general occasions. So,
fantastic.
Yeah. All sorts of neat stuff. And like I said, I mean, I'm very happy to be here. I came from Gettysburg, which is the previous theater.
Well, that's a great town.
It is. It's great. It's a little different from Reading, and I was excited to move here and take on a new theater and a bigger project. And the staff I have here is great. They're all local kids primarily. They're very friendly. They're great. They love the job, and you know, they do an excellent job of serving the customers and cleaning the theaters between each movie. And we try to do as much as we can to make it a great experience for everybody.
Yeah, I was greeted nicely at the door.
Great.
So, well, Dave, thank you so much. This has been great fun, very eye-opening, and I think I'm excited to come see an IMAX.
I know, I'm going to.
I'm even going to try the 3D, maybe.
What's your next showing?
Next one, 7 o'clock.
All right. There's a movie every night at 7. Or do they switch?
In general, well, the show times change every week. You can see them online at rctheaters.com or fandango.com. They're in the newspaper as well, or you can call a recorded line. The recorded message is 610-374-2828, and that'll list the movie times as well as some interesting events coming up and different things.
Anything happening in the summer? Any movie events or any...
Well, we actually have a couple things going on this summer. Starting in June, we're going to be doing a free kids series. It starts on Tuesday and Wednesdays every day, 10 a.m. There's going to be a free kids movie every week from end of June through August. So that information will be coming out pretty soon in the newspaper and on the website. We're also doing a continuation of the Metropolitan Opera. We started that back in the fall, and it was a live series that's broadcast live from the Met in New York.
Oh, I didn't know it was live like that. Oh, how cool.
It's really new, and we have a satellite technology up in the booth there, and it's broadcast live.
Do you have the translation?
The ones that are done in Latin or foreign languages, they usually have subtitle broadcasts along with it. We're also doing a continuation of that. It's a pre-recorded series that's going to start in June after our last opera, which is May 9th, La Cenerentola. And then so we'll have a series lasting through the summer, and then we'll pick up with the live series again in October.
That's so great. I mean, because a lot of times people who enjoy opera, you just can't get to New York, and that's the closest you can go, I think. So I think that's awesome that you're able to bring it right here.
It's a great program, and it's had a really great response. We actually we generally show it in one of our largest auditoriums, 250 seats, and we've come near selling out a number of those. And we actually had to add two additional auditoriums for Madame Butterfly. We had over 500 people come downtown to watch Madame Butterfly. It was great, and people really seemed to enjoy it, and it's a great presentation.
Excellent. Well, again, thank you for having us. I think this was awesome, and I would encourage everybody to come down and check it out. And I haven't been to the movies in a while, so this is a really good excuse. If you haven't been, come see the IMAX and just come out and check out this wonderful thing happening in downtown Reading.
I'm actually going to have to check out a movie.
Absolutely.
look comfortable in that.
I was comfortable. I'm going to get in trouble.
Because you were slouching. But I think that was a good advertisement, how comfortable the chairs were.
Oh, they were great chairs. You really could lean back and not have any obstruction with anybody in front of you.
It's like the stadium.
Yeah, it's really nice.
So nobody can be too tall in front of you. So it was fun.
It was
fun. I think I'm actually going to go see an IMAX movie.
What is Star Trek?
Star Trek, yeah.
I want to see that. What is it? 17? Is it 17 again? Is that what it is?
What?
I don't know.
17? The museum one?
No. It's a movie that's in now. It falls into
in the
river.
IMAX?
And, yeah, I think so.
I don't know what you're talking about.
I'll shut my mouth. Go ahead, Marcia.
Well, no, I was just going to say, I don't think we quite know where we're going for our tape segment, but we're going to have music live next month.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Is it Burnt Sienna?
Well, he plays for Burnt Sienna, so hopefully I'll check in with Rod and... But we have a good show.
Right.
But how about those magicians? You did very well.
They did a great job.
They did a great job, yeah. So, but anyway, thanks for being with us. And you were going to wish somebody, because I wish somebody happy birthday. Now you
yeah,
want to wish somebody
I thought
happy
of somebody
birthday.
That is having a birthday this month, May 26th. My brother Andy is having his 40th birthday. He's going to kill me, but happy birthday, Andy.
There you go. And again, happy birthday to Lita. See, just because I had a birthday, you had to have a birthday.
Well, you know what? She stole my community yard sale, so I had to...
But it's my community, too.
You're right, it is.
Anyway, thanks for joining us,
Thank
and
you.
We'll see you next month.
Good night.
Good night.